Welcome to the wonderful world of dance, bringing you exclusive interviews with top dancers and choreographers and reviews of the world's best companies across the globe. You can find lots more on our website at thewonderfulworldofdance.com.
Hi, this is Savannah Saunders from The Wonderful World of Dance, and today I am so excited to introduce Jinyup Cha, a Korean dancer, director, and famously the choreographer of the Winter Olympic ceremonies that occurred earlier this year, which many of us have watched on TV. Particularly the Winter Olympics for me was fascinating. So she's also known in Korea as a judge on the country's version of Dancing with the Stars. We are so lucky to have her coming over to London and presenting her choreographic work as part of the Korean of Dance, sorry, the Festival of Korean Dance being held at the place over a week, which will be presenting some extraordinary companies between the 9th and the 16th of May. So Jinyup joins us from Korea. Hello.
Hello.
I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly.
Yeah, perfect.
Thank you so much for staying up so late to talk with us from Korea. And you've got with you your translator, Susanna Choi. Hi, Susanna.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, nice to meet you as well. So, let's first of all talk about dance in Korea and what it was like for you growing up in Korea and learning dance. When did you start dancing in the first place?
저는 7살 때부터 약간 전문적으로 무용을 한 건 아니고 동네 에어로빅 학원 같은 데서 시작을 했어요. 그래서 7살 때 이제 무용을 아주 춤이라는 걸 재미를 느끼고 그리고 나서 10살 때부터 리듬체조를 시작을 하게 됐고 그 리듬체조를 하면서 사실 발레 어떤 기본을 또 배워야 되고 했었어서 발레학원도 갔는데 발레학원에서 이제 발레를 전공을 하면 좋겠다. 그래서 사실 클래식 발레를 그때부터 이제 전문적으로 하기 시작했어요. 그래서 이제 아트스쿨에 합을 했고 이후에 사춘기의 어떤 적대성의 혼란과 어떤 세상에 대한 관심이 뭔가가 생기면서 현대무용에 대한 매력을 느껴서 17살 때부터 이제 현대무용으로 전공을 바꿔서 지금까지 현대무용을 하고 있습니다.
So I started dancing when I was 7, and it was not a professional class that I started taking. When I first started, it was more of a hobby. I started as a hobby studio that were in the town. And then when I was 9 years old, I started doing rhythmic dance.
Rhythm gymnastics.
And in order to do rhythm gymnastics, I had to learn the basics of ballet. So as I was studying ballet, my teacher suggested that I take professional lessons. So I started taking professional lessons, and then from then on, I became a dancer, a professional dancer. And then when I was going through adulthood in my teenage years, and I started pondering about the meaning of life and more philosophical questions of, and that's when I became interested in contemporary dance, and I transferred from ballet to contemporary dance, and I've been dancing ever since.
And what was that philosophical questioning that you did? Can you describe the thinking between, studying ballet, but then you moved into contemporary dance? What was it about contemporary dance that made you make that change?
The 위해서 계속 반복 연습을 하고 어떤 폼에 내 몸을 어떻게 보면 맞춰야 되는 그런 훈련이에요. 그래서 사실 그런 거에서 막 한계도 많이 느끼고 어떻게 보면은 이제 좀 지루함을 많이 느꼈을 시절에 현대무용의 어떤 자유로운 표현이나 어떤 나만의 어떤 개성을 내가 어떤 나의 퍼스널티 아니면 어떤 뭔가 나의 개성을 좀 더 살려서 춤을 내가 더 자유로운 표현을 할 수 있는 그런 춤에 좀 매력을 느꼈던 것 같아요. 그래서 어떤 예쁜 발레리나의 어떤 폼에 내가 보다 나만의 춤을 좀 뭔가 찾는
같은 느낌? 네. As you know, ballet is very, it's very formatic. You know, it has its form, it's about perfectionism, it's about, you know, making a very perfect move through repetitive practice. So when I first was introduced to contemporary dance, I was very intrigued by its freedom, you know, the freedom of expression, being able to portray my unique personalities and my unique self through dance instead of becoming another pretty ballerina. So those are the uniqueness and the freedom of expression was what really attracted me to contemporary dance rather than ballet.
And you ended up coming to London and studying at the London Contemporary Dance School. Tell us about the difference between your experience learning contemporary dance here in London versus your experience back in Seoul, in Korea.
한국에서는 사실 조금 더 실기 위주, 테크닉 위주, 굉장히 약간 기술적인 부분들, 그러니까 무용술에서 정말 훈련을, 정말 이렇게 좋은 몸을 만드는 그런 훈련들 많이 했던 것 같아요, 다양한 스타일에. 근데 이제 영국에 가서 런던 컨템포러리 댄스 스쿨에서 이제 수업을 하고, 거기서 여러 안무가들을 작업하면서, 뭔가 움직임이 굉장히 더 내 스스로 다양한 것들을 내 스스로 발견할 수 있겠다. 이미 있는 것들을 습득하는 것이 아니라 내 스스로 어떤 새로운 어떤 컨템포러리 댄스를 만들어낼 수 있는 어떤 좀 그런 창의성에 대해서 되게 저는 좀 더 흥미가 있었던 것 같아요. 그 가면서 가시게 된 거죠. 그래서 뭔가 새로운 걸 배우고 싶었었고 한국에서 내가 어쨌든 컨템포러리 댄스는 서양에서 시작이 된 건데 한국에서 내가 경험을 많이 했다고 하긴 하지만은 그래도 또 본거지에 가서 그들의 교육이 어떤지 배우고 싶었고
When I was in Korea, I was able to learn the different techniques, you know, perfectioning my body and, you know, really becoming a better performer as a dancer performer and really, it was more about the techniques that already existed. It was a technique that was already formulated within the contemporary dance field. When I went to London, when I was going to London, I was aiming for more to work with choreographers and being able to discover a new technique that will belong to me. It would be my own experience. It would be my own expression instead of being something that was already formulated. So, contemporary dance, although it was already settled in Korea, it was born in the Western culture. So I wanted to go in the Western culture and really learn more about where it was originally born.
Sorry, keep going.
Yeah, does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely, it does. Yeah, it's sort of fascinating to hear your story and your experiences. And one of the experiences that you had whilst being over here is that you danced with Hofesh, who is one of my favorite choreographers. And I think it must have been very challenging to perform his work, in fact. Tell us about that experience and what was it like for you as a dancer?
굉장히 어떻게 보면 운이 좋았었어요. 그러니까 영국에 가자마자 처음 딱 첫 공연을 본 게 호페시스터 공연이었고 보자마자 아 이게 내가 이렇게 영국에 온 이유구나. 정말 이런 춤을 내가 춰보고 싶다. 내가 되게 갈망하던 어떤 댄서로서 정말 추고 싶던 어떤 그런 작품 그런 무대였었는데 그걸 눈으로 보면서 언젠가 저런 춤을 추고 싶고 이 안무랑 작업을 했다라고 굉장히 마음으로 이렇게 갈망을 하고 있었는데 마침 학교에서 호페시스터 안무가를 초청을 해서 같이 작업을 할 수 있는 기회가 생겼어요. 근데 이후에 또 운이 좋게도 호페시스터가 자기 컴퍼니의 저를 또 픽업을 해줘서 굉장히 자연스러운 위주로 표현이나 어떤 그런 다른 루트가 아니라 자연스럽게 만나서 저를 학교에서 발탁을 해줘서 시작이 된 거는 굉장히 어떻게 보면 좋네요. 너무였어요.
I was actually very lucky because the very first show that I went to see when I arrived in London was a fashion show. And I watched the show, first impression was, this is why I came to London.
Yeah.
This is the reason I'm in London. And I was very impressed with his work. And I wanted to, I had the desire to work with him at one point in my life. And then at that period, he was
perfectly in the
career. Yeah. The school had invited him to come and work as a choreographer at our school. And, you know, very naturally, I had the opportunity to work with him. And then later on, he invited me to come and work at his company. And it just transitioned very naturally. I was very lucky, I can say.
Yeah, very, very lucky. What did it feel like to actually perform his work? It must have been very challenging. His choreography is so, it looks so complex. What's it like to dance?
그 춤이
어떤
사실은 우선 첫 작업 같은 경우 그랬어요. 왜냐면 이미 봤던 작품에 너무 멋있는 여자 무용수가 했던 그 역할에 내가 리플레이스로 들어갔었기 때문에 너무 그걸 정말 잘하고 싶었고 그만큼 잘하고 싶었고 어쨌든 내가 이전에 해보지 않았던 어떤 스포츠 스타일을 새롭게 도전한다는 것 자체가 나한테 챌린지였지만 그게 스트레스나 어떤 힘듦보다는 막 도전하고 싶고 잘하고 싶고 막 그런 어떤 욕심과 열망 같은 거. 그래서 사실 그리고 또 하나 저한테 더 깊게 다가온 거는 호페시의 백그라운드가 어떻게 이스라엘이잖아요. 어떤 이렇게 중동 아시아의 어떤 그 나라에서도 사실 어떤 균형적인 어떤 그런 감정 그런 것들이 있어요. 감수성이나 어떤 감정들이 어떻게 보면 내가 되게 이해하기 쉬운 그런 표현들이 춤에서 나왔던 것 같아요. 그래서 사실 저는 굉장히 낯설지 않았고 오히려 익숙했고 그런 춤을 추는 게 그래서 이게 정말 어떻게 보면 내 춤 같다라는 뭔가 내 옷을 입은 것 같다라는 그런 생각이 들었었어요.
The first work that we got to do together was actually it was a performance that had existed before. It was not a first time work. So I was replacing a very
amazing
dancer that done worked so perfectly. So
wow.
It was quite challenging, you know, when I first started doing the show, it was a very, very unique and special moment for me. But it wasn't special in terms of being difficult or being like overwhelming or stressful. It was more of, you know, it was very. I wanted to do it really well, and it was a very. What would the word be? I'm trying to look for the
translation. So
for the right translation so that I can.
So sort of doing the performance or doing the piece justice or doing the role justice, I think we would say maybe.
Yeah, but it was a very enjoyable challenge. It was a challenge where we got to progress. We got to progress as a dancer. It was a good challenge, not a stressful challenge. As you know, he's an Israeli.
Yeah.
He has this Israeli background. So for me, it was easy to understand and easy to connect with some of his artistic philosophies that he portrays in his choreography. So, you know, me also being an Asian woman, it was very you know, once I got to dance with his choreography, I was able to really connect with his world. Yeah, so I felt like I was finally on the right choreography. I was wearing the right costume. I was wearing, you know, everything was so fit for me.
Wow. Amazing. And tell me about what inspired you to start creating your own work, and how did that experience perhaps influence or has it influenced how you approach some of your own work?
네, 호프 씨 이후에도 네덜란드 갈릴리 댄스 컴퍼니한테서 활동을 했어요. 근데 그 갈릴리 댄스 컴퍼니 이집 갈릴리도 바체바 출신의 그러니까 호프 씨가 있었던 같은 이스라엘 공간. 그래서 이상하게 2년 이스라엘 안무가들이랑 몇 차례 작업을 했었는데 그들의 어떤 훈련, 어떤 백그라운드의 가가 테크닉이라는 것가 있어요. 그 가가 테크닉이 갖고 있는 어떤 그냥 어떻게 보면 이게 피지컬 트레이닝이 아니라 그 이미지네이션, 그래서 어떤 생각과 감정 일치시키는 뭔가 자기 안에서 뭔가 이렇게 감정을 끌어내는 그런 움직임들이 사실 저는 한국에서 춤췄을 때 내가 추구하는 그런 방향의 춤이었었고 근데 그거가 명확하게 경험을 해보니까는 아 뭔가 나의 제 안무가 더 내가 안무를 하는 방향성이 더 정리가 된 것 같았었어요. 이전에 내가 한국에서 안무를 했던 경험이 있지만 그때는 그냥 막막하게 아 난 이런 춤을 안무하고 싶다 이런 춤을 추고 싶다 했는데 훨씬나 빈집 관련의 어떤 그런 작업을 하고 나서는 아 이런 안무 방식이 나의 내가 여태까지 추구했던 그런 스타일 이런 거였구나 생각이 들면서 굉장히 큰 영향을 받았던 것 같아요. 빈집 관련한 그들이 춤을 움직임을 안무하는 어떤 그런 메소드들이 저한테 굉장히 내가 추구하던 양의 답을 준 것 같아요.
After the experience with Jose Copes, I was able to work at the Italy Dance Company
in Holland.
In yes, Holland. That the dance company not exist anymore.
Okay.
Anymore, but you know, they are originally also this Israeli dance company. Yes, and a lot of the techniques that I was able to experience with them, as well as with Hofesi, was the gaga technique. As you know, it was instead of focusing on the physical performance, it was always about focusing on the inner philosophy and what we have our creative world, our aesthetics, our philosophies, and the world that we want to connect with, you know, the messages that we want to connect, right? So it was more about bringing what we have inside outside and, you know, portraying that and expressing those through our choreographies and our dance. So although I used to dance also in Korea, those two experiences have really inspired me to discover what kind of a dancer and what kind of a choreographer I wanted to be later on. So those experiences have been very strong in my artistic career.
And how would you describe your choreographic language or your language of movement? You were quite able to describe others. What about your own?
그냥 이건 아직도 계속 찾아가는 과정인 것 같아요. 계속 찾아가고 있고 계속 매 작품마다 좀 새로운 방식으로 또 시도해 보려고 하고 어떤 저만의 랭귀지가 있다기보다는 그냥 무용수하고 내 작품에 참여한 아티스트들하고 계속 커뮤니케이션을 하면서 그 사람을 계속 알아가는 과정. 그렇기 때문에 저는 되게 작업이 어떻게 보면 상대적이에요. 내 걸 주기도 하지만 그 사람을 계속 꿰뚫어보면서 그 사람을 계속 알아가고 거기서도 끄집어내려고 하고 그 한 명 한 명의 어떤 가지고 있는 어떤 다양성들을 끄집어내려고 보려고 하는
I still still a work in progress.
Mm-hmm.
You know, defining my language is still a work in progress, and it changes every time I do a new work. But I would say that the way I work is, instead of focusing too much on myself, I collaborate, I connect a lot with dancers that I work with the artists that I work with, and I try to discover what they have to bring into the table. I try to discover and really find out what they have to say and the benefits that they have. And then from then on, relatively find out how we can connect and how we can create a new work. So, instead of defining my own language, I think
그 사람이 누군지, 그 사람을 보고 그 사람이 갖고 있는 어떤 유니크한 어떤 움직임이든 그런 것들을 끌어내려고.
Yeah, so I try to with the dancers that I work with, I try to really bring in the uniqueness that they have inside of them and portray that into the work that we do together.
So tell us about the work that you're bringing over to London, which you're presenting as part of the Festival of Korean Dance at the Place.
The title is River Run.
그 비주얼 아티스트 파키하고 콜라보레이션을 하는 작업인데, 그렇기 때문에 이제 비주얼적으로 이 영상 패티 아트 비주얼이 굉장히 강한 작품이고,
it's a collaborative work that I did with visual artist Paki. She is a visual artist in Korea. And because she's a visual artist and a kinetic, so we have been using kinetic art in the work. And that's why the videos and the performances are very strong. They're very visual.
그래서 이 비주얼들이 시각적으로만 머무는 것이 아니라 제 움직임과 이것들이 합쳐져서 그것과의 어떤 교감, 그것하고 일체화시키고. 몸과 어떤 이 기계들의 장치나 이런 영상들이 어떻게 모하고 그들이 조화를 이루는지 그런 것들이 또.
So in this work, we focus a lot on how the videos, the movement of the video and the movement of the kinetic arts are combined with my own movement, and they create a totopito instead of they're not those in the background. But they're also part of the choreography, and the kinetic art movements are also part of the whole choreography.
And that seems to, for me, sort of reflect what I've read about you. You're not just a dancer or a choreographer, but also a director. So it seems like you are directing and choreographing the entire experience, the visual element in collaboration with your visual artist, and also the way the dancers move, and that coming together as one, as you say, rather than being two separate elements. And I'm sorry. No, that's okay. And I was just going to ask, the festival is obviously an amazing opportunity for people here in London to be able to experience and explore Korean dance, which is not something which we get to see every day. What does the festival mean to you, and for you to be able to come over to London with your work?
예를 들어 막 이렇게 이 페스티벌에 참여하게 되는 거죠.
Why is it important for you?
선택을 하시게 되는.
우선 계기는 우선
근데 먼저 다시는 거죠.
사실 제가 한국에 2008년에 들어왔어요. 그 거의 10년에 영국에 다시 가서 그거 자체가 전 설레일 때 되고 또 더 플레이스는 사실 많이 섰던 무대인데 10년 만에 그 무대를 다시 선다는 것 자체도 굉장히 저한테는 좀 되게 들뜨고 기쁜 일인 것 같아요. 근데 예전에도 그 레졸루션이라는 페스티벌이 있어요. 한국에. 거기서 안무에서 선보인 적이 몇 차례 있었지만은 그래도 좀 더 이제는 제가 어느 정도의 안무가나 무언가로서 이제 자리 느낌을 하면서 정말 내 작품이라고 할 수 있는 이런 큰 작품을 또 소개하는 거는 처음이기 때문에 사실 되게 떨려요. 네, 우리 한국 관객보다 더 떨리고. 네.
So I left London in 2008. So I'm going back to London after. So this show is going to be after a decade left London. And I have performed at the plays several times before, but going back there after 10 years, very meaningful and it's very exciting and by itself. But bringing in River Run at this time, I went to several other festivals, the Revolution and before that, but this time feels like I become into a more stable level in my career, or more realized choreographer and director and dancer. So it's very meaningful, and so to bring in a show that I can call my work to London. So that itself very exciting, and it's quite overwhelming at the same time. Yeah, so there's a little bit of anxiousness as well because of that.
It sounds like you're almost coming full circle in some ways. As you say, you studied in London, you've performed at the place, part of the Revolution, and now you're coming back. And you describe yourself, and perhaps it's the translation, as a more stable artist and realized artist, but also, I think, more accomplished artist. Perhaps you have... and that's quite a lovely full circle for yourself, but also for the place as well, I'm sure. And as part of that accomplishment, you're a judge on the Korean version of Dancing with the Stars, which I can't not ask you about. I can't imagine how many millions of people watch this all the time. Tell me about this version, the Korean version of Dancing with the Stars, and your role as the judge.
그냥 우선 되게 재밌는 해프닝은 어쨌든 그 첫 방송 이후에 바로 그 실시간 검색어 1위에 올랐다는 거? 그게 정말, 아, 이렇게 방송이라는 게 이런 거구나. 내가 여태까지 열심히 춤을 춰도 대중들한테 아껴지기가 쉽지 않았지만, 한 번의 방송으로 대중들한테 더 많은 사람한테 금방 알려지는 거잖아요. 제가 지금 보는 사람이 있어요. 그때까지 나한테 첫 방송으로.
So it was an opportunity to really realize the power. I have been dancing for over 10 years, really, 10-20 years, for decades before that, before the public actually recognized me. But after that show was, I was on the top search things on the Korean portal. And, in one day, after one single media appearance, that is still get, people get recognized in the street sometimes.
Wow.
So I was really amazed by the power that media has.
Yeah, so it sounds like you've become a bit of a celebrity over there in Korea. But, a worthy and a worthy celebrity, absolutely. So tell us, how is dance and contemporary dance perceived in Korea? What is the general sort of thought within the populace about dance in general? Is it something that is important to the Korean culture or...?
근데 사실 한국의 현대무용에서 굉장히 많이 지금 세계적인 흐름을 같이 가고 있고, 지금은 어떻게 보면은 거리상으로 먼 나라이기는 하지만은, 뭐 인터넷이나 온라인이나 이런 걸로 빠르게 공유가 되고 있고, 한국의 많은 무용가들 세계 진출 굉장히 활발하게 지금 하고 있고, 그래서 사실 지금은 어떤 그런 기회를 전혀 못 느끼고 있어요.
일반인들이
어떻게 보면 그 댄싱 라인이라는 프로를 관심인 사람들이 좀 많아지는 거가 첫 번째 되게 큰 역할을 했고, 그 TV 프로그램은. 그래서 이제 저 같은 경우도, 아, 뭐 예술의 대중화, 이런 말이 사실 좀 반감이 어느 정도 있었어요. 그렇지만은 그런 거를 보면서, 아, 어느 정도 우리가 대중분들한테 조금 더 이해하기 쉽게, 특히 한국은 사실 이런 좀 파인아트나 이런 컨템포러리 댄스 같은 일반인들한테 익숙하지 않은 분야이기 때문에 그들이 우리를 찾아오게 해달라고 하는 건 사실 먹고 싶다는 음식을 그냥 기다리고 있는 거는 아니잖아요. 오히려 그걸 먹을 수 있게 그 기회를 그냥 갑자기 우리가 먼저 다가가야 되는데 또 그런 역할로서 내가 뭘 할 수 있을까 생각이 들어서 사실 요즘에는 조금 더 그냥 극장 공연 어떤 무용계에서 일어나는 이런 공연들뿐만 아니라 좀 더 이렇게 사이트 스페시픽 퍼포먼스나 어떤 좀 다른 식의 어떤 매체라든지 그런 작업들을 저도 하려고 노력하는 것 같아요. 그러니까 그런 것들이 반응이 또 저도 빨리 느낄 수 있고.
So in terms of quality or the level of our dancers and our artists, I would say that we are almost, we grew very fast and we're almost equaling to level in a world-class level. A lot of the Korean dancers are going overseas and doing major performances. So I think we have grown into a very high world-class level of artists and performers and also creators. Having said that, the general public, because you asked about the perception of the general public, it is true that through this TV show, the Dancing Nine, we called it in Korea. It's yeah. The Korean version of
Dancing with the Stars. Or Strictly Come Dancing,
We call it Dancing Nine, and that through that TV show, a lot of the general public got introduced to contemporary dance and what it is, what this genre is, and a lot of the dancers have several fans, and the performances, the shows that they do after that, are becoming more popular. So before, I used to have a bias, against the generalization of fine arts, making it a popular culture. But at the same time, for people who did not know fine arts and giving them an opportunity to experience it and to appreciate it, it made me realize that it's very important as well. So after that, I was able to, think about and really reflect on the things that I can do as an artist to let more people. Are you still there?
I'm still here. Yeah.
Let more people appreciate the work that we do. So I try to, instead of, before I used to do only theater like shows, but now I'm doing more site-specific shows and collaborate with different artists that are in different fields so that we can come closer to the general public.
That makes sense. Yeah, it does. And that discussion or the consideration between the fine art and the accessibility of dance and introducing dance to new audiences is one which most certainly the work that you did in terms of choreographing for the Winter Olympic ceremony certainly, reached or presented Korean choreography and Korean dance to the world, really, who even broader than just in your own country, but actually reached out to a whole new audience that may never have ever in their consciousness thought about Korean dance or what's going on in Korea in terms of in choreography. Tell us about that particular project, because of the scale of the project must have been quite large, universal or worldwide broadcasting. Tell us about what that was like.
두 번째 이발이 되겠나? 아니면 좀 더 우선은 이게 지금까지 그래도 다양한 경험을 했다고
생각을 경험을 했었지만 가장 길고 2년 6개월 전에 저희가 임명이 돼서 2년 6개월 전에 첫 회를 시작해서 굉장히 긴 시간에 여기에 뭐 매일은 아니지만은 프로젝트가 2년 6개월의 과정이었고 가장 큰 규모, 정말 많은 인원과의 협업과 그 안에서 벌어지는 수많은 일들이 여태까지 살면서 겪어보지 않은 인간관계에서 오는 굉장히 네, 저의 어떻게 보면은 나를 다시 돌아보게 됐어요. 사실 나의 참을성의 한계치를 내가 보았고 내가 사람을 관계하는 어떤 나의 모습을 이렇게 다시 보게 되었고 극한의 상황에서 내가 어떤 사람인지를 또 경험하게 됐고 그래서 또 이런 과정뿐만 아니라 작업에서도 정말 말도 안 되는 추위와 정말 추웠거든요. 말도 안 되는 추위와 또 그 무수한 퍼포머들을 데리고 해야 되는 그런 큰 작업도 처음이었기 때문에 사실 모든 게 저한테는 다 도전했어요. 그걸 해내야 됐었고 그러고 하면서 다시는 이런 일은 나는 삶을 하지 않아야겠다라는 결심을 했지만 그렇지만 저한테 인생에서 정말 큰 교훈을 얻었고 만약에 하라고 그러면 또 할 것 같아요.
So I thought that I had experienced a lot in this life until the Winter Olympics. It was the largest, the longest, and the greatest, you know, in scale. Everything was it was very different. But it was just, the scale was large, so the people that we had to work with was large. Everything was, just the scale was so different, you know, the conflicts that we had, the episodes, and the challenges that we had to face, it was just greater than anything that I had experienced before that. It was a 3 year and a half long project.
Wow.
Like when I first was named for this, it was 2 years and 2 years and a half before. Although I was not working every day, but you know, the meetings and everything, it was just a long project. And in the midst of everything, it was very cold.
Okay, yes. The Winter Olympics.
Yeah,
snow everywhere.
You know, so there were so many different challenges that we had to work through every single day. Even against nature.
Yes.
That's what we're trying to get. But it was also a very good opportunity for me to reflect on me. I was able to reflect on the type of artist that I am, on the type of person that I am, and how I react in these kind of situations and everything. And you know, if you had asked me, I would say if I was offered another opportunity like this, I would probably turn it down.
Wow.
I would do it again. But having said that, at the same time, I would probably, if I'm offered with the same opportunity, I'll probably do it again.
Yes, of course you would.
Yeah. I would probably want to do it a better job than before.
Yeah.
Yes. So yeah, it was a large scale work that we had to go through, and and the outcomes and the fruits that we get from it and the experiences that we get from it was also very, very grateful.
Yeah, it must have been amazing. I did watch some of the Winter Olympics and it did look rather cold, I have to say. Just coming back to London, it's not quite so cold here these days as we're heading into the summer months. So when you come to London, what are you looking forward to the most? It's been, like you say, 10 years and you're back here. What are you looking forward to the most?
I 공연을 통해서 뭘 기대하는 거는 그러기보다는 어떻게 보면 중간 내가 조금 전
또 내 가정이라고 생각하고 저는 앞으로도 계속 무대에 서고 싶고 네. 지금 나이보다 10년, 20년 후에도 춤을 계속 출 수 있었으면 좋겠고 또 안무를 계속 하고 이 일을 계속 했으면 좋겠는데 그걸 지금 저는 하프웨이라고 생각해요. 그 중간 과정에서 내가 왔던 길 10년 전으로 돌아가서 그것을 어떻게 보면 점검하는 나의 어떤 중간 단계에서 그것들을 한번 점검을 하고 그 다음 스텝으로 가기 위한 나를 이렇게 점검하는 시간 같은 생각이 들어요. 사실은 이 공연을 계기로 좀 더 이후에 뭐가 될지 모르겠지만 내가 그냥 한 스텝 더 새로운 발걸음을 할 수 있는 어떻게 보면 여기서 네, 뭔가 한번 이렇게 점을 찍고 싶은 거 있잖아요. 내가 왔던 곳으로 돌아가서 내가 70년 동안 한 것도 이만큼을 했었다. 네, 그런 것들을 한번 잘 보여주고 그 다음을 또 뭔가 새로운 거를 좀 찾아서 또 이전에 내가 하지 않았던 작업들 그리고 또 네, 다음을 기약하면서 그런 의도가 있어요. 네, 그런
So I'll probably dance. I wish I dance after 10, 20 years and I still I'm still a choreographer and a director for the next few decades at least. So at this point, I think this visit to London is the midpoint of my career. So going back after 10 years to where it all started, I wish it is an opportunity for me to look back on what I've gone through in the past 10 years and how far I've come. So it's a really reflective opportunity and, you know, just check on where I'm standing, where I'm trying to go, and this mark of big exclamation mark or period on that midpoint of my career. Yeah, I think I'm looking forward to find the inspirations for where I'm going next as well.
And do you know where you're going next?
I'm looking forward.
You don't know yet. But as you say, you are the midpoint of your career and you do have decades left. And you've had quite a... And it will be very inspiring for not only current students of the London Contemporary Dance School and other dance institutions, not just here in London or the UK, but around the world, to hear that story of how you were a student and you presented work and you have gone on to have an extraordinary career. As you say, you know, you've through the opportunities you've had of creating some of the most extraordinarily huge works to some of the biggest audiences ever through the Winter Olympics and the TV show and taking dance more, you know, getting new audiences in Korea and across the world. In all that incredible journey that you've had and that accomplishment, what advice would you have for other particularly female choreographers, either in Korea and or listening, that you would give or words of advice that you would give to other creators or artists who are on their journey?
Mm-hmm. 지금까지의 작업을 한번 쭉 훑어보면 사실은 그 여성이라는 것이 항상 중심에 있었고 내가 여성이기 때문에 사실은 그냥 나의 어떤 나를 더 알아가는 과정이었던 것 같아요. 내가 어디서부터 온 사람이고 나를 둘러싸고 있는 사회의 모습이 어떤 것이며 그래서 나는 앞으로 어떤 방향으로 가고 싶은 그런 사람인지 그래서 항상 어떤 나의 중심이 있다 보니까 그것이 여성이었고 그래서 항상 작업들이 어떤 여성 중심적인 여성성이 두드러지는 그런 작업이었어요. 그러다 보니까 여성들한테 다른 여성들한테 관심이 많아졌고 그래서 사실 요즘 어떤 여성 이슈들이 많은데 그것들이 밖에서 그런 이슈들에 관심을 받는 것도 굉장히 중요하고 그런 걸 목소리를 내는 건 우리가 너무너무 중요하지만은 그냥 정말 나에 대해서 더 많이 알아야 될 것 같아요. 사실 저는 그래서 지난번에 작업도 정말 내가 태어나기 이전에 우리 여성의 모습들이나 어떤 나의 뿌리 공간 이런 것들을 좀 더 발견을 하면 내가 더 단단해질 것 같고 내가 더 단단해지고 나의 중심이 더 잡히고 사회에서 아무래도 여성이 약자일 수도 있기는 하지만 아직까지는 그렇지만 거기서 내가 내 목소리를 낼 수 있고 나의 어떤 문제, 나의 정체성 이런 것들이 힘이 생기면 어디에서든 흔들리지 않을 것 같은 그런 생각이 들어서 저는 계속 나에 대한 관찰 이런 하고 있는 것 같아요.
Through all of my work, women have always been the center of it. Women have always been on the center of my work and the universe that, of the works that I've created. And it's not because, and it's more because I was always focusing on myself. I was always focusing on what person I, what do I have, what do I want to communicate to the world, you know, what kind of voice do I want to do. Have in this world, in this society. So as I was focusing on self, I was focusing on what I am. So where I come from. So I was, so therefore I was looking into what it means to be a woman in this world. And just this past work that I was deeply, you know, focusing on, you know, even focusing on what it means to become a woman, even from before I was born. And that has really helped me find my voice and become strong, very fond, strong with person. Mm-hmm. Person and having a concrete voice, having a strong, concrete, a very firm voice within the work that I do. So my advice to, you know, to other dancers is really focusing on what they are and on their inner self, you know, where they come from, you know, what their roots are or what their foundations are. And that is going to give them a strong voice, and that is going to be portrayed on any work that they create.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much for those wonderful words, and looking forward to River Run, which is at the Festival of Korean Dance in London at the Place from 9th to the 16th of May. Thank you so much. Looking forward to seeing your work when you come over to London. Thank you so much for joining us, and make sure you visit theplace.org.uk to get your tickets to see River Run.
Don't forget to subscribe. We've got some incredible interviews coming up with principal ballerinas and renowned choreographers. We love dance and ballet, and we hope you'll love us. Join us on Facebook and Twitter.